for this. We are live on the Facebook as well. We'll be starting in just 2 minutes. Yes, attendees can post their Q&As in the Q&A section. They can post their questions and queries in the Q&A box, right, given at the bottom of your screens.
Attendees are required to check with their chat box. We will be posting, sharing the link for Google Form to give the feedback. And on the basis of the feedback, we will be providing the e-certificates to the participants.
Yes, before we go live, there are just these instructions. Keep a paper and pen handy with you to be a part of this webinar, because a lot of calculations will be a part of this. If you have any query, you can post it in the Q&A section. Keep checking the chat box for the form and definition for the feedback form as well. We will be posted at around the end of the session. And based on that, you will be just given the e-certificates. We will be going live now. We will be starting with the session within a minute, less than a minute now. Sir, should we go?
Yes, sir.
We can start. Good morning, everyone. I, Aman Pratap Singh Pal, Faculty School of IT, on behalf of APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus, Jalandhar, welcome you all to this webinar on fantastic mathematical techniques to crack aptitude exams. Heartiest welcome to Dr. Rajesh Bagga, Director, APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus. Welcome, sir. The panelists for today are Dr. Kulwant Kaur, Dean, School of IT. She has more than 20 years of experience under her belt. And Mr. Daljeet Singh Matharu, both are faculty of School of IT, APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus, Jalandhar. The speaker of today would be Mr. Rohit Verma, who is also a faculty of School of IT, of APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus. I welcome all the attendees of the webinar who have spared this precious time to attend to this. I would now request Dr. Kulwant Kaur, Dean, School of IT, to address the audience with the brief introduction of the institute and about the speaker of today. Kulwant ma'am, please.
Very good morning to you all. It gives me immense pleasure in welcoming all of you to live webinar on fantastic mathematical techniques to crack aptitude exams, and extend heartfelt thanks for being here. APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus in Jalandhar, Punjab, being part of India's one of the most prestigious education society, APJ Education Society, has been rendering its services in the field of engineering, management, and information technology for last two decades. APJ Education Society, having more than 50 years of excellence in the field of education in India, offering pre-nursery to doctorate level quality education, and have around 60,000 plus strong alumni network across the world. APT Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus offers a spectrum of programs approved by AICT, and institute is affiliated to IKG, Punjab Technical University. We offer BTech CSE, BTech CSE with specialization artificial intelligence and machine learning, and BTech CSE Internet of Things, cybersecurity, including blockchain technology in engineering and technology fields. MBA, BBA, BCom programs are offered in management area, and MCA, BCA programs are offered in computer application areas. At APT Institute of Management and Engineering, we look at overall development of students. Technical campus has experienced faculty, with each faculty member expertise at a particular field or area. Institute has excellent placement record for master's and graduation courses. The institute runs employability enhancement program, which is compulsory for all programs, which hones up aptitude and technical skills at various levels of the student and provide overall development of the students. We also organize entrepreneurship awareness camps to enhance skill set of the students. There are various clubs at the institute like marketing, finance, HR, sports, IT, NSS, name a few, for which a student can become a member and contribute towards it. These clubs actively participate in organizing intra-institute activities and facilitate the students to participate in inter-college events. Institute has well-equipped lab, having latest hardware configuration and separate hostel for boys and girls. I would like to share that in tough times of the lockdown, AMTC continued to impart education to the students by shifting to online e-learning mode by having interactive sessions through Zoom, cloud meetings, of Moodle for attendance as well as for the assignments. Today, Mr. Rohit Verma, Assistant Professor of Technology, will, with an experience of more than 15 years, will deliver a talk on fantastic mathematical techniques to crack aptitude exams. It will be beneficial to the students who are willing to appear and crack aptitude and mental ability related competition exams. We are here to encourage and appreciate and nurture our young talents. I expect that this interactive session by Mr. Rohit Verma will be productive and will be enjoyable and fruitful to you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for briefing about the institute and about the speaker of today. I would now invite Director of the Institute, Dr. Rajesh Bagga, to please address the audience. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Amit and Aman and Dr. Kulwan. Thank you so much for briefing about APJ Institute of Management and Engineering. First of all, I would like to welcome all the attendees in this webinar, Fantastic Mathematical Techniques to Crack Aptitude Examination. My dear friends, Dr. Kalvan shared about the brief history of our campus. Let me say a few words about this. Our APJ Institute of Management and Engineering comes into existence in the year 1997. And it is one of the institution under the umbrella of APJ Education Society. Out of the total 26 institutions, around 11 higher educational institutions and 14 APJ schools in the entire country. And apart from this, the APJ Satya University established in the year 2010. So the founder chairman, Dr. Satya Paul, established the APJ Education Society in the year 1967. And now the legacy of APJ being carried forward by the only daughter of Dr. Satya Paul, Madam Sushma Paul Barlia. So we are really glad to share with all of you We know the tough time is going ahead, due to the COVID-19 pandemic. But successfully, our faculty and our students, they are able to go by the online Zoom classes. Apart from this, the Moodle platform being used for sharing the e-resources. And apart from this, regularly in last 2 months, we have already organized around 6-7 webinars with regard to different areas. Because we are having School of Information Technology, School of Engineering, School of Management. In School of Management, we are offering our MBA, BBA, and BCom honors program. And in case of School of Information Technology, it is about the MCA and BCA program. And in case of School of Engineering, it is about BTEC, Computer Science and Engineering. And because of the upcoming developments with regard to the IT field and the engineering, we have just taken approval from All India Council for Technical Education for 30 seats in BTEC CSE, Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning, and 30 seats in BTEC CSE, Internet of Things, Cybersecurity, including Blockchain Technology. So let me share with all of you, my dear friends. Reason being, the education scenario in the country is going like this. Whenever we are discussing, it is the talk about the employability of students. Whosoever is pursuing any of the degree, that may be the BTEC, MBA, MCA, BCom, BBA, etc., or BCA, it is a general discussion about the employability of students. So with regard to the employability of our students, we are doing a lot of efforts, and we are organizing this group discussions, personal interviews. And the foremost requirement in case of employability, whenever you are going for any of the multinationals or for appearing in any of the interviews, the first hurdle is about the aptitude test. And now a number of students, they are waiting for their JEE exam, AIEEE exam, etc. That's why we are coming up with this webinar, Fantastic Mathematical Techniques to Crack Aptitude Test. And during the webinar, I am quite optimistic with the vision and with the techniques being shared by Mr. Rohit Verma, speaker of the day. We will be benefited, and definitely in case with regard to the shortcut techniques, etc., you will be having certain queries. We will try to resolve number of queries through the Q&A, not to be in the chat box, but in case if some queries being left, definitely we will try to answer, and later on we will share the email ID of Mr. Rohit and the ID of our campus, so that later on you can be in touch with the campus in order to go for a certain sort of workshop. And we are, in coming days, we are also planning to organize short workshops in order to go for the mathematical techniques to crack aptitude test and a number of webinars in the hierarchy. So we will share all this. So thank you so much. I hope all will gain out of this webinar. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. And before we start with the webinar and before we proceed with it, I would request the participants to post their questions in the Q&A section only and not in the chat box. And I would also request them to keep a paper and a pen handy, because there would be quizzes with which they can solve along with Mr. Rohit Verma. We will now invite Mr. Rohit Verma to please start with the webinar. Mr. Mir Verma.
Thank you, Aman sir. Thank you very much. Good morning all. It is generally observed that in aptitude and mathematics related exams, a lot of time is wasted while making the calculations. Though certain patterns are available over there, but instead of recognizing these patterns, we apply traditional techniques to solve these questions, as a result of which a lot of time get consumed. So in today's webinar, I will share some interesting mathematical techniques with all of you, with the help of which you can save ample time and you can manage that time in some other questions. So without further ado, let's start. Yes. The first pattern, you might have noticed that sometimes we have to find the product of two numbers which are very, very close to 100. Fine. So this technique will help you to find the product of all those numbers which are very close to 100. And by applying this technique, we can find the product very easily and at a very high speed. For example, here you can see we have two numbers, 102 and 104. If we apply traditional mathematics to find the product of these two numbers, it will be very time consuming. So what we will do, we will subtract 100 from this first number, and you will notice that the difference is 2. Similarly, we have the second number, we'll subtract 100 from this number, and the difference will be 4. Now, what you have to do, you have to find the product of these two numbers and write the answer in double digit format. Now, you know that 2 multiplied 4 will give you 8. So, we'll write here 08. Now, this 4 is available here. You have to add this difference to the first number. 102 plus 4 will give you 106. So, this is the complete answer. You can see in a matter of seconds and just a single line, we are getting the answer of these two products. To better understand, once more, we can consider one more example. And you can try these examples with me also by taking your own pen and pencils. Now you can see here, we have the number 106. Again, the difference is 6. And in this case, the difference is 9. Now, if you find the product of 6 and 9, it is 54 written here. This 9 is added to the first number 106. Answer is 115. So this is the final answer. Fine, got it? Now we have next technique. In some cases, it is possible that number instead of greater than 100, maybe possible that number is lesser than 100. In that case, we will apply another technique. The technique is similar. Now here, you can see we have two numbers, 92 is there and 94 is there. Again, we will subtract 100 from this 92 and you get here minus 8. Similarly, 94 minus 100 will give you minus 6. Now again, we will find the product of these two and write the answer in double digit format. Minus 8 multiply minus 6 will give you 48. The 48 is written here. Now we have 92. This minus 6 is added to this 96 and answer is 86. 86 is written here. Next example is here, 96. Now we want to find out the product of these two numbers. You can see here, again, the difference is minus 4 and here the difference is minus 1. Now we can find the product. Product answer comes out to be 04. Don't write only 4. Keep this thing in mind. You have to write the answer here in double digit format. So it is 04. And now we will add this minus 1 to this first number, or you can add this minus 4 to the second number. Means cross addition is required. Whatever addition method you can use, either you can add this minus 1 in the first number, or you can add minus 4 in the second number, you will get same answer. So 99 minus 4 or 96 minus 1 will give you 95. And this is the final answer. Keep this thing in mind that these methods will increase your speed. Fine. Otherwise, if you use some traditional method again and again, I am telling you, traditional methods are required to understand the concepts. But if you want to crack the exam, if you want to save the exam, if you want to save your time, then you need these techniques, and these techniques will prove to be very helpful during the examination. Next, we have the case when one number is greater than 100 and another number is lesser than 100. Now, in this case here, you can see we have 102 and we want to find out the product of 102 with 94. Again, we have to subtract 100 from this 102. Difference is 2. And here we have 94. In this case, the difference is minus 6. Now again, you have to find out the product of these two numbers. And now the product comes out to be negative minus 12. Now what you have to do, you will subtract this minus 12, sorry, you will add this minus 12 to 100, and answer comes out to be 88. Answer comes out to be 88. So I will write the 88 answer here. Now keep this thing in mind, this is 102, take one less of this value, that is here we have 102, but we will write here 101. Now this 101, to this 101 we will add this minus 6. To this 101 we will add this minus 6, and answer comes out to be 95, which is written here. Fine.
One more example is Rohit here. Rohit sir, there is one request. Please repeat this particular technique once again.
This one?
Yes, this one, sir.
Okay, sir. We are repeating the technique with another example. Now, in this case, you can see we have 104. Fine. We have 104. We will subtract 100 from this 104. Answer comes out to be 4. And in the second case, 99. Again, if we subtract 100 from 99, answer comes out to be minus 1. Now, what we will do? We'll find the product of these two numbers. Here, the answer is minus 4. In the previous method, I told you that you have to add this difference to the upper number. But in this specific case, instead of adding the number to the upper specific number, you have to add it to the number 100. Fine. So 100 minus 4 will give you...
Rohit, just to interrupt, there is one question coming from one attendee.
Yes.
Whether it is possible to discuss ki this technique, means how much close a number to 100 so that we can apply this technique. Means this technique is applicable in what kind of cases?
Yeah. Actually, sir, this thing depends upon the concentration of the student. For example, let's suppose that I have 125. Fine. I want to find out the product of 125 with 125. So in this case, what can we do? We can find the difference here, 25, here 25, and then we have to find out the product of these two numbers. So depending upon the student, means to how much value he or she can find this product, up to that number, he can make this calculation. For example, my concentration allow me to compute up to 134, yeah, 135. Say 135 square, I am telling you, answer will be 1225. Similarly, if we have 175 square, in this case, the answer, again, I can write the answer, say, we can say we have 95. Now, in this case, 95, I can write the answer 9025. So it means that depending upon the concentration of the student, means how much product he can compute, depending upon that value, he can use this technique. I will discuss this technique later on with the higher numbers also. Now, in this case, I was telling you that the difference was 4, and here the difference was minus 1. We'll find the product of these two. Answer is minus 4. We will add this minus 4 to 100, and answer is 96. This 96 is written here. Now, again, we'll take one less of this value, 104. Instead of 104, we'll take 103, and we will add this minus 1 to this value. 103 minus 1 will give you 102, and this is the final answer. So in this way, we can find the product of those numbers which are very close to 100. It depends, again, I am telling you, it depends upon the student that up to which difference he can make the calculations verbally. In that case, he can apply these techniques in those methods. Now we have next technique. You might have noticed that in some cases you have to find out the product of any number with 11. Of course, if you use some traditional methods, say we have 1, 2, 4, again we want to find out the product with 11, we'll write here 4, 2, 1. So a lot of time is wasted. So what I will do, I will tell you the technique with which you can find this answer in just a matter of seconds. And no doubt in further slides, I will tell you how to check these techniques also. I will discuss some methods with the help of which you can check your calculations also with these techniques. Now let's see how easy to find the product of any number with 11. Yeah. Firstly, this 2, write this 2 on this side, written here. And this 1, which is present on the leftmost side, is written here. Now you will see the wonder. You have to move from right hand side towards left hand side, and you have to find out the sum of 2 digits at a time. Say 2 plus 5 will give you 7. 7 is written here. 5 plus 4, 9. 9 is written here. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 is written here. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 is written here. 2 plus 0, 2. 2 is written here. 0 plus 1, 1. And this is the complete answer. So in this way, you can find the product of any number with 11 by using this technique. I hope you can try. Yes?
Well, sir, there is one another question related to this. If we get 3 digits number on multiplication of last 2 digits, then what we should write? Because, sir, you told that we have to use 2 digit numbers like 0444.
Sir, actually, in that case, we will use a generic method. In the coming slide, I will discuss this generic method also to find the product of 3 digit, even 2 digit or 4 digit number. But in this case, you can see here, we are using this specific technique to find the product of this greatest number, we can say larger number with 11. So definitely in the coming slides, I am discussing the generic method with you, and you can apply those generic method to find the product, any product. You can find the product of any number of digits with any number of digits. Fine.
Very good.
Now I was discussing this question, this problem. We have this number and we want to find out the product of this number with 11. Again, we will write this 4 on this side and write this 8 on this side. Now you will say, instead of writing 8, I have written here 9 in the answer. Okay, this is because of carry, I'll tell you. Now 4 is written here. You have to add this 4 to this 1. Answer comes out to be 5, written here. Then we have 1 plus 2, 3. 3 is written here. Again, we have 2 plus 1, 3. 3 is written here. Again, 1 plus 2, 3. 3 is written here. And finally, 2 plus 8 will give you 10. 0 is written here. And 1 is the carry. This carry will be added to this 8 to make it 9. So this is the final answer. So in this way, you have seen that by using this technique, we have calculated the product of any number with 11. Keep this thing in mind. It is not limited to the number of digits in the number that you want to multiply with 11. You can take any number of digits. You can take any number of digits. It depends upon your requirement. And by doing so, you can find the answer just in a matter of seconds. Next technique is to find the product of any number with 12. Again, we'll use this technique. This technique is also very interesting. You can see here, we have 12 and we want to find out the product of this number with 12. Technique is a little bit different. Here, we have this 2. Now, double this 2 and write the answer here. Double this 2 and write the answer here. 4. Here we have 4. And this 1 is written on this side. Now, what you have to do, you have to take the second digit, double it, and add it to the previous value. The double of 5 is 10. When 10 is added to 2, it becomes 12. Fine? So 2 is written here, 1 is the carry. Next we have 4. Next we have 4. Now double of 4, Just a minute. Yeah, this 2 is written here. 2, double of 2 is 4. 4 is written here. Then we have 5. Double of 5 is 10.
Is not audible to us?
Yes, now it is it audible?
Your voice is echoing. Yeah. Now it's so it's yes. audible. Yeah.
Go on, sir.
It was echoing. Please continue.
Audible.
Yeah. Now we have this. We have this 2. Double it and write the answer here. 4. Now we have next number, digit 5.
Yeah.
Double it. Double of 5 is 10. When this 10 is added to 2, it become 12. 2 is written here. 1 is the carry. Now we have 4. Double it. It become 8. Now 8 is added to the 5. Answer is 13. Because of this carry, we add this carry. Answer is 14. 4 is written here. Now we have 3. Double it. It becomes 6. 6 is added to this 4. Answer will be 10. This carry is added. It become 11. So 1 is here. 1 is the carry. Now we have 2. Double it. It becomes 4. And 4 is added to 3. It becomes 7. Then 7 is added to 1. We'll have 8. Now we have 0. Double it. It becomes 0. 0 when added to 2. It becomes 2. 2 is written here. Now finally we have this 1. Double it. It becomes 2. This 2 is added to this 0. Answer is 2. And 1 we have already written. This is the complete answer. I hope you understood this. We can consider one more example so that you can better understand. We have this example. In this case, again, starting digit is 4. Double it and write the answer here. 4 double of 4 is 8. So 8 is written here. Now we have this 1. Double it. It becomes 2. 2 is added to this previous 4. It becomes 6. And now we have this 2. Double it. It becomes 4. 4 plus 1 will give you 5. 5 is written. Then we have 1. Double it. Become 2. 2 plus 2 will give you 4. 4 is written here. Then we have 2. Double it. Become 4. 4 plus 1 will give you 5. 5 is written here. Then we have 8. Double it. 16. 16 plus 2 will give you 18. 8 is written here. Now we are left with only 1. I already told you that you have to write this 8 in the beginning. Now when this 8 is added to this 1, it become 9. And 9 is written here. This is the final answer. So in this way, you can see we have make the calculations, calculate the product with 12, with 11, with very easy techniques. Fine?
Yes.
Now, this is the generic method. Because in previous method, I told you that the number should be close to 100 or the number multiplication of a number with 11, with 12 means this kind of stuff, concepts we have discussed. But now I am discussing with you the generic method. With this generic method, you can find the product of any number with any other number without noticing any pattern. But in this case, you have to apply the crisscross method, this method. This method is very easy, but you should remember this pattern in your mind. Fine? To understand the concept, here we have 52, and we want to find out the product of 52 with 43. Means there is no limit that the number should be close to 100, less than 100, greater than 100. This thing should not happen. This is a generic method. So what we will do, in this case, we'll find the product of these 2 digits. 2 multiply 3 will give us 6. Now we multiply cross digits. This with this one and this with this one. In this case, 3 multiply with 5 plus 4 multiply with 2. Means this 3 is multiplied with this 5. And this 4 is multiplied with this 2 and get the sum. Now 3 multiply 5, 3 multiply 5 will give you 15 and 4 multiply 2 will give you 8. 8 plus 15 will give you 23. So 3 is written here. We have written 2 digits. 3 is written here. 2 is the carry. Now we have to find out the product of these 2 digits.
Sir, one request from a person. Please restart it. Repeat this particular method again.
Okay, sir. I'm repeating this technique once again. In this technique, what you have to do, firstly, you should find the product of rightmost digits, these 2 digits. 2 multiply 3 will give you 6. You can see I have written here also. 2 multiply 3 will give you 6. 6 I have written. Now you have to find out the cross product with sum. 5 multiply 3 will give you 15. Plus 8 multiply 4 multiply 2 will give you 8. 8 plus 15 will give you 23. So 3 is written here. 3 is written here. And now 2 is the carry. Now finally you have to find out the product of 5 with this 4. 5 multiply 4 will give you 20. Plus this 2 is carry. So 20 plus 2, you will get 22. In a single digit, you are in a single line, you are getting the product of 2 digit numbers. Otherwise, you know, you have to use this, then cross again, then in this way you find the answer. So a lot of time is used, but by using this technique, you can write the answer in a single line. We can consider one more example, then we will move further. Here we have 5162. Please try to solve this question with me using your pen and paper. In this case, we have 1 multiply 2 will give you 2. Cross multiply, 5 multiply 2 will give you 10, 6 multiply 1 will give you 6, 6 plus 10, 16, 6, 1 carry, and finally 5 multiply 6 will give you 30, 30 plus 1, 31, this is the answer. So in this way, single line, we are getting the answer. I am again saying that try to solve these questions, these problems with me. And please pen down these techniques with you so that in future you can review these techniques and use in your exams. Now, next technique I am going to share with you. Now we have a quiz time. You have 5 questions in front of you. Try to solve these questions just 2 minutes. Try to solve these questions just 2 minutes. Please.
I'll keep the time for 2 minutes. Meanwhile, the attendees can post their questions and queries in the Q&A box. One minute is over. We have answers in the chat box as well. Let's see if they are correct or not.
Dear participants, please write question number and the correct answer, A, B, C, D.
Yes, time's up.
Yes, we got the answers.
Yes. In the next slide, you may match your answers. Yeah.
We got the answer for question number 1, 2.
Please match your answers. Yeah. Now let's move towards the next technique. These techniques are very, very easy and very interesting also. You can find this product in just a matter of seconds. I will tell you how. Firstly, you should notice the pattern in this question. You should notice that the tens place digit is same, 3. And unit place digit sum is 1, 8 plus 2, 1. So while solving these problems, what you have to do, just find the product of rightmost digits, that is 8 and 2, it is 16, written here. Now multiply this 3 with the next digit. The next digit to 3 is 4. So 4 multiplied 3 will give you 12. This is the answer. That's it. Similarly, try to solve these two questions in front of you. We have 4 and 6. Again, 24 is written here. The next digit to this 4 is 5. So 4 multiply 5, 20. This is the answer. I hope now you can solve this problem, this question yourself and find the answer. And write the answer in the chat box. Hurry up. Yeah. I have to repeat this technique. Just a minute. There is some attendee who want to repeat this technique. You can see here. Yes. Yeah. In this case, what you have to do, firstly, you should notice that the sum of unit place digit is 10. 4 plus 6 will give you 10. And the tens place digit is same. You can see here. What you have to do, just write the product of rightmost digit, that is 6 and 4. Answer is 24, written here. And the next digit to this 4 is 5. 4 multiply 5, 20. Written here. This is the final answer. And for you, I am solving this problem also. 3 multiply 7 will give you 21, written here. The next digit to 7 is 8. 7 multiply 8, 56. This is the answer. That's it. Now we have next technique. Yeah. You know, getting the square of some specific number is very interesting and very easy also. If somebody asks you to find out the square of 35, if you are using traditional method, of course it will take time. If someone asks you 95 square, of course it is a time consuming process. Similarly, we have 65 square, time consuming process. Now you should notice that there is a specific pattern in this case also. The rightmost, the unit place digit is 5. So, in order to find the product of 35 with 35, means if you want to find out 35 square, just you have to write 25 here. In all the cases, you should notice that 25 is written. And now, multiply this tens place digit with the next digit. Next to 3 is 4. So, 4 multiply 3 will give you 12. This is the answer. In this case, half answer I have already written, 20 I have already written. So next to 5 is 6. 6, 5, 6 multiply 5 will give you 30. This is the answer. In this case, 72, 25. So keep this thing in mind. If you are answering these questions, you should answer in this way. This 65 square, answer is 25. 42, 25, this is the answer. If somebody asks you 55 square, here you should write 25 and here 30. 30, 25 is the answer. Say 95 square. You should write here 25, 9, next to 9 is 10. 90, 25 is the answer. So in this way, you can very easily calculate the squares of these specific patterns. Now we are moving towards the next technique. Yeah. In the previous method, I have discussed with you the crisscross method to find the product of two-digit number with two-digit number. You know, you can apply the same technique to find the product of three-digit number. Say, you want to find out the product of three-digit number with three-digit number. Or even, you can extend this technique to any digit numbers, but depending upon your concentration. Because you have to multiply using crisscross method, and in some cases, we lose the concentration, and instead of writing the answer, correct answer, we move toward the wrong track. So keep this thing in mind. After concentration and after doing a little bit practice, you can apply these techniques to 4-digit multiply 4-digit number, 5-digit multiply 5-digit number, like this. Now let's start. In this case, I've used this pattern. Now how to remember this pattern? Keep this thing in mind. You have to start from the right hand side, and in the starting, you have to consider only one line. Then you have to increase the line by one step at a time, moving towards left hand side. Here you are using two lines, here you are using three lines. When you reach the maximum value, say 3, now you have to move in the backward direction, means you have to decrease the number of lines. Here 3, here we have 2 lines, here we have 1 line. I am talking about this line. I am talking about this line. Here we have 2 lines. Here you have 3 lines. I am talking about these lines. Fine. So let's see how to find out the product. Now in this case, firstly, I have multiplied these two numbers. 2 multiplied 3. 6 is written here. Now cross multiply. 3 multiply 1 will give you 3 plus 2 multiply 2 will give you 4. 7 is written here. You can see here 7 is written here. Then we'll take the product of 3 digit with 3 digit, but in cross manner. 5 multiply 3 will give you 15 plus 4 multiply 2 will give you 8. 8 plus 15 will give you 23. Plus 2 multiply 1 will give you 2, 23 plus 2, 25, 5 is written here, and 2 is the carry. Now you have to work with these two numbers. Again, cross multiply, 5 multiply 2 will give you 10, 4 multiply 1 will give you 4, 4 plus 10, 14. But because of this carry, 14 plus 2 will give you 16, 6 is written here, 1 is the carry. Now in last, 5 multiply 4 will give you 20 plus this carry 21, and this is the final answer. Now you can see in a single line you are writing the product of 3 digit number with 3 digit number. I already told you, you can extend this technique to any number of digits depending upon your requirement, 4 digit, 5 digit, 6 digit, etc. Fine. Now let's move towards the next technique. Yeah. You know, we have 50 series. In some cases, we have to find out the square of 50 series. 50 series means 51 square, 53 square, 58 square, like this, 57 square even, like this. So, getting the square of these numbers is also very, very easy. What you have to do, let's see in this case, we have 52 square, this one. Now, write the square of this number, rightmost digit, 2, and write the answer in double digit format. 2 square will give you 4, write the answer in 0, 4. Now, add this 2 to the value 25. Always in all the cases you have to add the right digit to 25 only. So 25 plus 2 will give you 27. This is the answer. You can consider one more example. 59 into 59. Just 9 square, 81. Now this 9 is added to 25. So 25 plus 9, 34. This is the answer. You can consider one more example here. Please try to solve this question yourself and check whether you are getting the correct answer by using this technique. Please apply.
All right. Meanwhile, I'm typing in the feedback form link. Kindly please fill this up for the e-certificates. Kindly click the link. If you it doesn't get redirected, kindly copy and paste it in your browser.
We request the quiz attendees to fill their names properly.
Yeah, please go ahead, Mr. Mataru. Please go ahead.
Yeah, we request the attendees to fill their names properly because the same will be printed on the certificate. So, okay.
Fine. Fill in the email and the name very carefully. And the quiz part is optional part. You can skip it or you can attempt it. Thank you. Rohit sir, please continue.
Yeah. Now, let's firstly, I will discuss this last question also with you. 54 into 54, again, you know, we'll get 16. 16 is written here. Now, 4 is added to 25, 29. 29 to 16 is the answer. Now, let's move towards the next technique. Yeah, Now it is the time to check the calculations. You know, we have done a lot of calculations. We have done product, we have done squares also. Now I'll discuss with you the technique of checking all these calculations, whether you are performing correct calculations or not. We'll discuss these techniques one by one. Now, in order to understand this technique, keep in your mind that 9 means 0. Keep this thing in your mind that 9 means 0. Fine? 9 means 0. And second thing that you have to keep in your mind is single digit sum. For example, we have 2, 9, 3. You have to write the answer in single digit format. You have to find the sum of digits. I have the number 293. But if you find the sum of these digits, it comes out to be 2 plus 9 will give you 11. 11 plus 3 will give you 14. But instead of writing 14, we will write 5. Because we have to write the answer in single digit format. 14 means 1 plus 4, 5. Fine? Now, in front of you, on this screen, you have two calculations, two additions are there. Firstly, in the first number, three numbers are taken. And their sum is written here. I want to check whether the sum is correct or not. I told you earlier that 9 means 0 and you have to write the answer in single digit format. So in the first number, this one, wherever 9 is the sum, delete it. 4, 5, 9, delete. 6, 3, 9, delete. We are left with only 2. Similar method is applied in the second case also. You can see here 3 plus 4 plus 2, they are forming 9. Cancel them. We are left only 12. 12 means 1, 2, that is 3. Now finally, in the last, here we have 9, deleted, 4, 5, deleted, we are left only 1, 2, 3. Fine. And even in the answer, you have to perform the same task. You can see here, this value 4, 1, 4 will give you 9. Leave it. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. Here you are getting 8. Now, if you find the sum of these digits, if answer comes out to be 8, it means your calculation is correct. You can see here 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8. Calculation is correct. Fine. We can consider one more example. In this case, you can see we'll cancel these four digits because 4, 5, 9, 7, 2, 9. We are left with only 3. We have written here 3. Here we have 7, 2. Delete it. 9. 9. Delete it. We are left only 3, 4, 7. 7 is written here. Now we have 4, 5. Again 9. Delete it. 9. Delete it. 7 plus 8 will give you 15. 15 means 1 plus 5. That is 6. 6 is written here. In the final answer, we have 2, 7. Delete it. We are 1, 5 and 7. 1, 5 and 1. Here we are getting 7. Now you should notice that when you calculate the sum of these digits, answer should be 7 and you are getting because 6 and 3 again 9 cancel, we are left only 7 and because this answer is equal to this answer, so calculation is correct, sum is correct. Fine. Now let's move towards the checking of multiplication. Yeah. We have discussed a method like to find the product of any number with 11, then square of numbers, like this kind of stuff we have calculated. Now we will check those methods also, whether they are working properly. You can see here. In this case, this 9 cancelled. In this case, we are getting the product of this number with 11. Sorry, just a minute. We are getting the product of this number with 11. And I have written the answer here. I have written the answer here. Now, firstly, you should notice that this 9 will cancel. This 2 and 7 will cancel because they are making 9. 4 and 5 will cancel. They are making 9. We are left with only 1 and 3 and sum is 4. Similarly, in case of 11, the sum is 2. Now, in this case, we are getting 8. Let's see whether we are getting 8 in the answer also. Now here you can see 9, 8, 1, 9. This part is showing you 0 because all phonemes 9. Now we are left with only left part. 7 plus 4 will give you 11. 11 means 2. 2 when added to 8 become 10. 10 means 1 because 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 when added to this 7, it become 8. Yes, we are getting 8. Answer is correct. This technique is correct. Fine. Now we have another example, this one. 85 into 85. You know, 85 means 13, that is 4. Again, 85, 13, that is 4. When you get the product of these two, in the previous case, you were getting the sum. Now, in this question, I am discussing with you the multiplication means you have to apply the same technique. If you are getting the sum of two numbers, you have to add these numbers. If you are getting the product of the numbers, you have to find the product of these numbers. Now in this case, 4 multiply 4 will give you 16 and the sum is 7. Now answer, we should have 7. 72, again 9, 0. We are left with only 25. 25 means 2 plus 5, 7. This is the final answer. So in this way, you can see, we can check any type of calculation. Next, we have another technique. Yeah, again, quiz time. Please try to solve these questions by using the techniques we have learned so far and write the answer.
Again, sir, I'm keeping the time. And meanwhile, I must request each and one to post your questions and queries in the Q&A section and not in the chat box. Kindly don't raise your hands because we won't be able to take your audio for that. If you have any query, please post it in the Q&A section. There is a question in the chat box that when will we receive the certificate, sir? As soon as possible, we will be delivering your e-certificates through the online, through your emails. So kindly fill in your emails and name very, very carefully. You can post your correct answers in the chat box with question one, answer this, question two, answer this, A or B part, or directly with the answer. A minute is over.
Yeah, participants are active. They are sending the answers.
Very good. That's
many
great.
Of them have solved 2-3 questions so far.
That's great.
I think Akanksha solved all questions. First,
yeah.
Answer is given. Second, it is C. Then first part, answer is B. Like this.
That's great. That's great.
That's good. That's good.
Let's have a look on the answer. Please match your answers.
Deep, Avinash.
So first, B is right. Second, it is.
It's a correct answer. Second is also correct.
So wonderful.
Okay.
That's great.
Let's move towards the next technique. Now we have divisibility test.
Well done, Avinash, Kushdeep, Avinash.
Yeah. Divisibility test. It is a time to check the divisibility test also. You have seen that in some situations we need to check whether the given number is divisible by 2, whether the given number is divisible by 3, 4, 5. In some cases, the task will become very difficult if the number falls away, far away from the list. So now I am going to discuss with you some divisibility techniques. Basic techniques, I am going to skip here because divisibility test of 2 is very simple. The last digit should be 0 or even number. In case of divisibility test of 3, the sum of the digits should be multiple of 3. 4, last two digits should be divisible by 4. So these are the basics. I am going to skip these method. If you want, I can discuss these methods later on. But I am going to start with 7, divisibility test of 7. Let's see. We can consider this example. We want to check whether this number is divisible by 7 or not. Firstly, write the number here. 8, 6, 3, 9, 4. Now, pick the rightmost digit and double it. 4004 is 8 written here, and subtract. Now again pick the last 8, double it, and subtract. Again, last digit is 1, double it. Now we know that 84 is divisible by 7. So this complete number will be divisible by 7. Keep this thing in mind. You have to repeat these steps until you find a number that is completely divisible by 7. Now in this case, you know 84 is divisible by 7. So I have left the task here, and the complete number is found to be divisible by 7. I hope you understood. We can consider one more example. Second case, this one. Here you can see we have 8, 4, 8, 6, 3, 8. Again, last digit 8, double it, then subtract. Now 13 minus 6 will give you 7. And here 5 minus 1 will give you 4, 8, 4, 8. Now 7 is the last digit. Again double it. 14, 0, 7, 4, 8. Again 0, double it, 0, 7, 4, 8. Double it. We have here 14. I think we have committed some mistake in this case. 70. No, now 70 is divisible by 7. So complete number is divisible by 7. This is the divisibility test of 7. Next is the divisibility test of 8. Very easy. You don't need to make any kind of calculations while checking the divisibility of 8. Just check the last three digits. If the number formed by using these last three digits is divisible by 8, the complete number will be divisible by 8. You can see 896 is divisible by 8, so complete number will be divisible by 8. Similar is the case with 728. If last digit, the number formed by last three digits is divisible by 8, the complete number will be divisible by 8. Next, we have divisibility test of 9. Now, in case of divisibility test of 9, what you have to do, you have to find out the sum of the digits. For example, in this case, we have this number and we want to find out the sum. 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 5, 15, plus 6, 21, 23 plus 4, 27. Now 27 is divisible by 9, so complete number will be divisible by 9, sorry. Complete number will be divisible by 9. Similarly, in this case, if you find the sum, answer comes out to be 36. And you know that the 36 is divisible by 9. So this complete number will be divisible by 9. Next technique is meant for number 11, divisibility test of 11. In front of you on the screen, I have written a very large number comprises of number of digits. And we want to check, we want to test whether this number is divisible by 11 or not. Very simple, very easy. You have to start from the left hand side and find the sum of odd place digits. Odd place digit means first place, third, fifth, then seventh, then ninth. If you calculate the sum of these digits, answer comes out to be 27. Now, whatever digits left, you have to find out the sum of those digits, means even place digits, 7, 9, 3, 0, and 8. In this case, sum will be 27. Now you have to subtract these two. If you are getting the answer 0 or multiple of 11, if you are getting the answer 0 of this difference, if you're getting the answer 0 or multiple of 11, then your complete number will be divisible by 11. You can see this one. By chance, in both the examples, the difference is coming to be 0. We are getting the difference 0. But in some cases, you will get the difference 11 or 121 also. Means if you are getting the differences of multiple of 11, then again, the number will be divisible by 11. So this is a case of divisibility test of 11. Next, we have divisibility test of 12.
Sir, screen sharing has gone, I think. We cannot see your screen now.
So, but it is visible to me.
Okay, fine. Now it's there.
Maybe
a problem at my side. Okay.
Okay, okay. Now we have divisibility test of 12. It is also very interesting. You don't need to make any kind of calculations. If required, little bit calculations are required in this case. What you have to do, you have to check. Firstly, we have 12. And the factors of 12, we have 3 and 4. Fine. Now, in this case, any number which is divisible by 4, divisibility test of 4 is last two digits should be divisible by 4. Here you can see 36 is divisible by 4. And similarly, in the second example, 64 is divisible by 4. So, firstly, you should check whether the number formed by using last two digits is divisible by 4. If it is, then you should apply the divisibility test of 3. Means you have to find out the sum of all the digits. Now, in this case, the sum is 48. Now, you can see 48 is divisible by 3. Means divisibility test of 3 is passed and divisibility test of 4 is also passed. So, the number will be divisible by 12. Fine? The number will be divisible by 12. In the second case, the sum of the digits, that is 4 plus 6, 10, plus 4, 14, plus 2, 16, 21, 22, then 27, then 36. 36 is the sum. And this sum is divisible by 3. And the number formed by using last two digits is 64. It is also divisible by 4. So number has passed the divisibility test of 3 as well as 4. So the complete number is divisible by 12. Let's move towards the next technique. Yeah. Very interesting technique. You know, in your lower classes, you have calculated the cube of a number. Today, I will discuss with you a different method of calculating the cube, because it is very easy to find the cube of 1 cube. Say you can write 1, then 2 cube, you can write here 8, then 3 cube, 27. Means you can write the answer very, very easily. Now, if somebody asks you, you have to find out the cube of 2-digit number. Okay? So, it will become problematic for you. But now, don't worry. You can apply this technique and you can find the answer very easily. Okay? Please concentrate. We have here 21. We want to find out the cube of 21. What should we do? Write the cube of 1 on this side and cube of 2 on this side. Clear? Cube of 1 is 1 written here. Cube of 2 is 8 written on this side. Now take the square of this 2 and multiply it with the second number. Now 2 square will give you 4. When 4 is multiplied with this 1, answer is 4. Write the answer here. Similarly, take the square of this 1 and multiply with this 2. 1 square means 1, multiply 2 will give you 2. So I have completed this line. I have completed this line. Now very easy. In between we have 42. Just double it and write here. 42 double 84. I have written here. Now get the sum. That's it. 1 is written here. 2 plus 4, 6 is written here. 4 plus 8, 12. 2 is written here, 1 carry. 1 plus 8, 9. This is the answer. So in this way, you'll be able to find the cube of any 2-digit number. To understand the concept, Again, we can consider the second example. In this example, I have included the carry also. Okay. So please concentrate. Here you have 13. You want to find out the cube of 13. Again, 3 cube means 27 written here. But keep this thing in mind. The answer's right digit, in this case 2, should be subscript, and the second number should be written as it is. Means in case of 27, we'll write 2 small, 7 large. Similarly, if we have 38, so we will write 3 small and 8 here. Fine? In this way. The reason for this is that you have to consider these values as carries. Fine. So you can see here, 3 cube will give you 27 written here. 1 cube is 1 written here. Okay. Now you have this 2. Now what you have to do? Take the square of this 1 and multiply with this 3. 1 square will give you 1. 1 multiply 3, 3. Similarly, 3 square is 9. 9 is multiplied this 1. You will have 9 here. Now you have to double it. Fine. Double of 3 is 6. Double of 9 is 18. 1 8. Now you have to add. This 7 is written as it is. 2 is the carry. 2 is moved forward here. 9 plus 8, 17 plus 2, 19. 9 is here. 1 carry. Now already 1 carry is here. 1 plus 1, 2. Here, 6 plus 3 will give you 9. 9 plus 2 will give you 11. 1 is written and 1 is the carry. That 1 is added to this, and final answer is, this is the cube. In this way, you can find the cube of any 2-digit number. Let's move towards next technique. The next is the case of percentages. You know, getting the value of percentage is very, very easy. But in some case, instead of applying methods, we apply traditional methods, and the answer is received a little bit late. Now, in this case, try to understand. I am writing here some values. 100% means same number. 100% means same number. 50% means half number. 25% means 1/4 of the number. 10% means in the number you have to put a decimal point after the rightmost digit. For example, 24, you will write here 2.4. And in case of 1%, you have to put the decimal point after 2-digit, after leaving the 2-digit from the right hand side. You can see here. Now, keeping these concepts, we have the next problem. You can see here. Yeah. Now, let's suppose that we want to find out the 51% of 36. 51% means 50% plus 1%. 50% means half. 36 half will give you 18 written here. 1% means you have to leave 2 digits from the right hand side, put the decimal point 0.36. Get the sum. 18.36 is the answer. 51% of 36 is 18.36. Similarly, we have one more example. Yeah, 11%. 11% of 68. 10% of 68, this is 6.8. 1% of 68 means after leaving the 2 digits from the right hand side, you have to put the decimal point 0.68 and get the sum. 8 is written here. 6 plus 4, 14, 4, 1 carry, 7, 7.48. This is the answer. You know, there are some patterns for which you can apply these techniques. These techniques are not meant for all the patterns, we can say. In some cases, there are some specific patterns, and by mistake or by chance, we lose those patterns and we apply traditional methods. If you are getting those patterns, you should apply these techniques to get the answer fastly. Now again, you have one more quiz in front of you, and you have to apply the techniques to find out the answer.
I'm keeping the time again for 2 minutes. You can post your queries in the Q&A, and please don't raise hands because we won't be able to take your audio. Professor, there is one question. Can you tell some techniques for fraction percentages?
Yes, there are fractional percentages techniques are also there, but we can discuss these techniques because they will take a lot of time also. Because we have next, we can say next session of this webinar also. In that series, I will discuss these techniques with you because today I have a lot of stuff to discuss with you. Now onwards, I'm going to start.
We are already running out of time. Already running out of time.
Yeah, because now I have to discuss the concepts of aptitude, then reasoning also.
Yeah.
So that is the reason. Of course,
we discussed
the new technique.
Aman, I think what we can do, reason being, I was going through the Q&A and number of times attendees, they have mentioned, ki kindly repeat this, repeat the cube of 23 or the 63 like this. But because of the paucity of time, I don't think we are able to take all the questions. But what we can do, we can share our mail ID in chat box so that all can copy it, and later on whosoever will be interested, they can write it to us, and definitely we will conduct some Zoom classes for those in the form of workshops, 3 days workshop, 7 day workshops. That is also possible. So this way we are in a position to facilitate our attendees. So I think this can be done. So meantime,
very true, sir. Very true.
There are many participants who have given the answers. Please show the answers now.
Time's up.
Match your answers. Please match your answers.
Okay, sir.
Participants have given the correct answers.
That's great. That's great. Wonderful.
Yeah.
That's great. Now let's move towards the next method. Now I am going towards the aptitude part of this webinar. Here you can see sometimes clock related problems are asked in the exam. Clock related problem means, now let's suppose that the time is say 2 o'clock. What will be the time in the mirror image? You have to write the answer. Fine. So in order to solve these kind of problems, what you have to do, you know, on the clock you have 12 hours, 12 marks we can say, which can be written as 11 hours and 60 minutes. Now what you have to do, you have to just subtract your time from this value. Here, if the exact time in the clock is 3:12, then what will be the time in the mirror image? Here we have 11:60, subtract 3:12 from this value, and after subtraction you are getting this answer, 8:48. So this is the answer. That's it. Similarly, in the another technique, in some cases it is asked that the clock is showing some time, say 5:30, and you have to find out the angle between the arms of the clock. We have to apply some techniques. Now I am going to discuss with you a technique related to this. Now in the present case, you can see the time is 2:20. Now firstly, 2:20 time is converted into hours, means 2 hours plus 20 by 60 hours, because 20 is in minutes, we have to convert it into hours. Fine. So you are left with 2 plus 1 by 3. When you solve it, you will get 7/3 hours. Fine. Now his answer is in front of you. You should apply this method, this formula. 30H minus 6M means 30 multiply H. H means 7/3. So 7/3, this will cancel with this one. We'll get here 10. And here 6 multiply M. M means 20. 120 is here. You can see. Now if you find the difference, answer comes out to be minus 50. Ignore the negative sign. Answer is 50. So the angle is 50 degree. This is the case. So in this way, without making much calculations, you can give the correct answer. Next, we have calendar related problems. In these problems, generally asked, we have this question. If the day fall on 15th March is Sunday, what would be the day on 17th of November? Any guess? Yes.
Yes, come up in the chat box or Q&A related to the
Any
answer.
Any guess?
Monday. Person has written Monday as the answer.
Monday. Okay. Let's see the answer. Keep this thing in mind. In every year, the calendar of March is repeated in November. Fine? The calendar of March is repeated in November. So if on 15th March, it was Sunday, it means 15th November is also Sunday. 16th Monday and 17th Tuesday. So Tuesday is the correct answer.
Yeah, even two students have given the right answer as well. Congratulate Mushkan Patia and Shabnam.
That's great. Answers. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. The calendar of month March is always repeated in the month of November every year. Next, we have this question. This question is also a little bit interesting. You can see here, today is Monday. What would be the day on 65th day? Please answer the question in the chat box. Hurry up. If today is Monday, what would be the day on 65th day?
Wednesday is Avinash's answer. Vishal has said Wednesday.
That's great. Let's see. Now keep this thing in mind. If today is Monday, every multiple of 7 will give you Monday. So it means that 63rd day is also Monday. So 64th day, Tuesday. 65th day, Wednesday. Wednesday is the correct answer.
So, correct answers we have received. Great. That's great.
A number of attendees have given the right answer.
Okay.
I'd like to congratulate Sumit.
The students are applying these techniques. That's great.
Continue, sir. Continue.
Yeah. Next one is, I'm going to skip this part. The next topic that I'm going to discuss with you, counting the diagrams. You might have seen that in some exams, you face the problems of counting squares, rectangles, means these kind of stuff. So now I'll discuss with you these kind of concepts, and all these techniques are very, very interesting. You can see in front of you, you have number of squares and you have to count the total number of squares, small squares present in this diagram, all the squares present in this diagram. So let's see the technique, what you have to do. Firstly, while solving these problems, you should write the counting from the left hand side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the same manner here, in the row wise, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Fine. Now you will see the answer. Here you can see, you have to consider this greatest number in the row and greatest number in the column. Okay. So I have to write the answer. 5 multiply 4 plus. Then you have to I have written here 5 multiply 4. Then you have to subtract 1 from each number. 5 minus 1 will give you 4. And next will give you 3. So 4 multiply 3 plus 3 multiply 2 plus 2 multiply 1. And now you should find the sum of all the products. 20 plus 12 plus 6 plus 2 is 40. This is the answer. Okay. So these are the total number of squares, boxes available in this diagram. Next, you should notice that in this case, number of rows and number of columns are not equal. If the number of rows and number of columns are equal, in that case, we have this method. Say in this case, you can see you have squares, number of rows and columns are equal. Now you should apply this technique. Again, you should write the counting 1 to 5, here also 1 to 5, and write the squares. 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, 5 square, and get the sum that will give you the number of squares. 55 is the answer. So in this case, you'll get the answer 55. Next is the case of counting the number of lines from non-collinear points. Non-collinear point means points are not present in a straight line. Here we can see we have 6 points present on the circle, and if you want to find out the number of lines by joining these points, you will have this technique. Just count the number of points. In this case, we have 6, multiply, reduce 1, 5 by 2, cancel, this will give you 15. This is the answer. The last technique, the next technique that I am going to discuss with you is calculating the triangles. Now in this case, you have triangles in front of you. You want to calculate the number of triangles. Any guess? Any person who can count the number of triangles in this diagram, please write the answer in the chat box. Yes. Okay, let's start.
27, 15. Sir, we are getting a varied of answers. So you please solve this problem for us.
Okay. Let's see. This is the answer in front of you. Here you have to write the counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Get the sum. Answer is in front of you. So the greatest number is 6. 6 increase 1, 7 by 2. This will cancel with this one. So answer is 21. Answer is 21. Fine? Very easy, very simple. Next question is, yeah, in this case, you have to count the number of triangles. Now, this is again very easy. In order to count the number of triangles, smaller triangles or all the triangles in this diagram, just you have to write the counting and the maximum value will give you the total number of triangles in this diagram. You can see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to count the number of horizontal lines only. This one. Okay. So, 5 is the answer. 5 is the number of triangles. Next case. Yeah, little bit complex. We want to calculate the number of triangles in this diagram. Again, what should we do? We should write the counting here. 1, 2, let's see. Yeah. We should write the counting here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And again here. 1, 2, 1, 2. And separately you can count. In this case, you will have 6 multiplied 7 by 2, 21. And this case will give you 1 plus 2. 3, and this case again will give you 1 plus 2, 3, total sum is 27. So 27 is the final answer. 27 is the final answer. Now again, last quiz in front of you. Please write the answers in the chat box.
Keeping the time as well. Meanwhile, you can post your queries in the Q&A. on AU. So we have started giving the answers.
So we have the questions for answers for question number one.
Attendees are participating interactively in this session.
One minute is up. Let's share the screen, sir, with the answers now.
Okay, please match your answers. Yeah. Please match your answers.
Let's move forward, sir, now.
Okay. That's all about today's webinar. Thank you for attending this webinar. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hope you have enjoyed the session.
Attendees, if you have any type of a query, you can post it in the Q&A so that I can take up with Mr. Rohit Verma.
Rohit, meantime, attendees, they must be raising some of the queries quickly. We can discuss. Whatever the tips and tricks being discussed by you, definitely there must be some exceptions to this rule, and there are certain circumstances, and for that purpose, how much time we require in order to understand the different lacunas in these tips and tricks. So this is my question on behalf of number of attendees.
Okay, sir. Sir, actually in this case, you know, while using traditional mathematics, we have spent a lot of time while learning those techniques, normal techniques, addition, subtraction, basic calculations. We have spent a lot of time. But in order to learn these techniques, we need just 1.5 hours, 1.5 weeks, we can say, to learn all these techniques, because today I have discussed with you just 10% of the total. So a number of techniques are available, and by practicing these techniques again and again, and by using the code out in the beginning, students will find difficult to use these techniques, maybe possible, because they have not practiced these techniques. With passage of time, they can learn these techniques in just 1 week, and that would be sufficient for the students. And they can apply these techniques wherever required.
So there is one interesting question coming in Q&K, how to master these techniques. And definitely you can answer this question, how to master these techniques. And second, the very interesting solution is given by Dr. Vidya.
Yes.
In her question, she has given some answer as well. Only practice, I guess. So if we implement these techniques in primary level, then everyone start loving maths.
That's great.
The
reality,
idea. So definitely we will try to put this idea to the academicians, and definitely to the primary education as well as the lower level, and then higher secondary education. So how to make a mathematics an interesting subject? So generally there is a fear among number of students with regard to the mathematics. So good one suggestion being given by Dr. Vidya. So Aman, any other queries, please?
Yes, there is one question regarding this. Let me go through it. Are there any methods or techniques related to these fast mathematics other than these?
Yeah, a number of methods, as I told you, that today I have discussed just 10% of the total. It will take, say, if someone wants to be master in this concept, in this, we can say, field, say, aptitude and reasoning, it will take approximately 1 month so that he or she can learn these techniques. Aptitude-related techniques are there, then reasoning-related techniques are there, then fast mathematics calculation-related techniques are there. So I think approximately it will take 1 month to master in all these techniques. And today I have discussed with you just 10%.
Okay, Rohit, is it possible ki in case if we want to conduct a workshop for 7 days or 5 days workshop, 1 hour each through Zoom classes, and in case if some of the students, they are interested, maybe 10 in number, 20 in number, depending upon the queries being raised through the mail ID. So whether it is possible to have this short workshop like 5 to 7 days, 1 hour session each, around 40 to 50% of the syllabus with regard to these techniques?
Yes, sir. Of course, it is feasible for the students to conduct this kind of workshop, and student will gain a lot while attending this kind of workshop. Of course.
So, Aman, I suggest ki please share the email ID of the institution so that anyone can raise their query for such kind of workshop, and definitely we can think upon this. Reason being, the best part of this COVID-19, which we can say, otherwise definitely it is disastrous for the economy as well as for the for the mankind. But in case now we are closer to the world at large, and this way we can arrange some of the sessions, and we can provide such kind of online education to some of the participants. So I think in Q&A, you can put your email ID, please.
So there was a very good question from one of the anonymous participants that she has not taken the mathematics in plus one, plus two. Would she be still able to learn all these mathematical tricks?
Yes, sir. Mathematics is very, very easy. But you have to do the mathematics differently, we can say. There are myriads of techniques to learn. Mathematics is not difficult, but depends upon the way in which you are studying this mathematics or subject, we can say. So I am telling you, he or she can very easily, very comfortably can learn these techniques. There is no issue.
And sir, one of the...
There is a participant who said that whether there will be another session like this. Dear participant, we have given you a feedback form in which we have asked for any other type of session you need. You have to give the topic and we will arrange the session accordingly. Aman, continue.
Yes. So, there was one more question regarding this only. They wanted to know the, what about if the calculations go beyond these three digits? Are there tricks for that also?
Sir, I already told you that I can calculate the product of 5-digit number or 6-digit number with 6-digit number in a single line, because it allows my concentration. So I am telling you again, it depends upon student concentration. For example, I am telling you, say somebody asked me what is the square of say 38. I will tell him 1444 is the answer. 39 square, 1521 is the answer. Okay. So like this, 2022, 484. So it means that all is practice. A student can very easily calculate the product of 3-digit, 4-digit, 5-digit number, or even 6-digit with 6-digit. Very easy techniques are there. You can extend to any number of digits. It depends upon your concentration.
They should be glued to our webinars, which are going to happen in the next sessions.
Hello, pardon?
We must look forward for the webinars that are going to take place with us. We will be training those techniques in that.
So definitely.
Okay, one last question is there from Dr. Vidya only. Sir, are these techniques called Vedic mathematics?
Some of these techniques are taken from Vedic mathematics. But if you talk about aptitude and reasoning part, means counting the diagram, this is not a part of Vedic mathematics. Vedic mathematics, initially I have done in the beginning, that was the techniques from Vedic mathematics.
Okay, so
I think what I'm getting, I'm not a teacher of mathematics, but what I can guess. So definitely all these techniques and these tricks for cracking the aptitude test, these are basically required and mandatory for all the students, whether the student is pursuing the MBA program or the student is pursuing the, definitely for BTech, it is of course mandatory. In case of MCA, it is again mandatory, but even for BBA, BCom, all students, I think they should learn such techniques. Reason being, ultimately, when they are targeting to for joining any of the MNCs or the to the corporate sector, the preliminary requirement generally in case of corporate sector, that will be the cracking first, the aptitude test, and then they align group discussions or the personal interview, and definitely that will be a very useful area which you discuss. So thank you so much, Mr. Rohit. And you touched number of points highlighted 10% of the total curriculum of fantastic mathematical techniques to crack aptitude test. So Aman, please over to you.
Thank you, sir.
So I guess we okay. So we don't have any questions like this. So let's wrap up with this now. Thank you very much, Director sir, for providing us this opportunity. I also thank all the participants for this. It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks for this extremely wonderful webinar. And I, Aman Pratap Singh, on behalf of APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to our resource person of today, Mr. Rohit Verma. You have been excellent today. Thanks to Director Sir, the panelists, Dr. Kulwant Kaur, Mr. Daljeet Mataru, and very much thanks to Mr. Santosh Mishra, who has been handling all this webinar technically. See you all very soon on another webinar. Thank you very much, all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. And a special thanks to Vatsala ma'am from Vatsala, head of the CPJ Education Society, New Delhi. She arranged a very effective Zoom session. And thank you so much, Vatsala ma'am. And thank you all panelists and the speaker of the day, Mr. Rohit.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, everybody.
Santosh, you need to end the meeting.